and welcome to Ark Training. My name's Simon. In this video today, what we're going to do is we're going to have a look at Microsoft Stream. So Microsoft Stream is a really cool streaming service that we can actually, if I can spell it right, if we can just go to stream.microsoft.com, and then obviously we log in with our Office ID. So I'm just going to click sign in. I'm going to sign into my account, and here's my top secret password. Okay, so what Microsoft Stream does is it's really cool. We can actually create videos sort of offline, and we can actually upload them into somewhere like Teams, which is great. If we actually have a look in our Teams for a moment, we can see different teams that I'm in. Let's just click Star Wars for the time being, and we can actually put in a stream video. There's a stream icon just there, and if I click that, I can paste a link from Microsoft Stream and I can insert a video from Microsoft Stream. So how do we do that? Well, actually, it's really, really easy. We can actually record videos offline. We don't have to do it online with Stream running. We can actually record them through our webcam or from like OBS Studio, something like that. And then we can actually upload them. Or what we can do is we can click Create. What we can actually do is we can record whatever we want to, really. We can upload a video, live event, group, channel, or record screen. So I'm just going to click on record my screen. You can see that the camera is selected for my Toshiba laptop, and the microphone is exactly, you know, it's coming from my laptop as well. And we're going to record the screen. And it says up here, by continuing, you agree that obviously it complies with our organization's applicable terms. By the way, yes, it does. And you have the necessary rights and permissions from people in your video. There's only me. And that your video will not violate the copyright, privacy, or other rights of others. So obviously it won't. So I'm just going to cross that out. So I'm actually going to start recording now. And it will give me a few little things that I can record. So I can record my entire screen, I can record just a single application window, or I can include a particular tab off. I use Chrome, so I can actually record my Microsoft Stream tab. That'd be interesting. But what I'm going to do is, just for the time being, I'm just going to show you, I'm going to record my entire screen. Okay, and then we click on the bit that says the entire screen, you push share, and then we get a countdown, 3, 2, 1. And we've now got a 15-minute window where I can record something. So this could be, I'm sitting at home, and let's just say, for the sake of example, I've got some small children. They don't go to bed till 8 o'clock at night. During the day, it's very difficult for me to record videos or stream videos. However, when they go to bed at 8 o'clock at night, I've then got some peace and quiet where I can actually record my videos. Once I've recorded my video, which I will have in a moment, I'm going to push next. Oh, by the way, you can obviously pause. So let's just pause. And you can see that we've actually kind of, there we go, pause. And we click again to record more. So for the sake of example, we're waiting for something to finish uploading or loading or whatever. We can just click on pause. And then when it's finished, we can obviously come back to that. So let's just click start recording. Gives you that 3, 2, 1 countdown again. And we continue recording. When we've finished, we can either push pause or we can push next. I'm just going to push next. And here's my video. I can obviously play my video. One. And we've now got a 15-minute window where I can... Okay. I can record again, so I can ditch that, start again. I can actually just ditch it completely and not even bother starting again. I can leave feedback if I really want to. Or I can upload to Stream. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to upload that to Stream. So we're going to put this on as a stream. Oh, what should we call it? Stream tutorial. Why not? Stream tutorial. I can put a description in there if I wish to. So let's just type a description. Video languages is English. Everybody in our company or organization, or in our case, our school, is going to have access to this. If I untick that, not everybody's going to have access to that, and then we can actually figure out where we want to put it. But I'm just going to put that tick in that box. You can see it's coming up with processing, and I'm actually going to publish that. So processing is now stuff that's going on behind the scenes. I will have just received an email, I think, that's actually told me that I've got a Microsoft Stream recording coming in. Let's have a look. And with any amount of luck, maybe not. It'll pop up later, I'm sure. So let's just go to video. It says processing complete. So I'm going to go to video. Really should mute these things before I start.
And we've now got a 15-minute video window where I can record something. So this could be I'm sitting at home, and let's just say, for the sake of example, I've got some small children. They don't go to bed till 8 o'clock at night. During the day, it's very difficult for me to record video.
Okay, so there's actually our video. That's no problem at all. What we can now do, because we're interested in doing this, we're going to put share. And what we're going to do is we're going to share our video. So we're just going to copy that link there. And if I go back into my Teams, where I pushed on stream, we can actually insert that link, push search, and then Microsoft will actually eventually, he said, hopefully, find it, he said. Go on, hit enter. There we go. Microsoft Stream Video. And that's our stream video. If I now post that, that is in our stream. It's on our general channel in our Star Wars. And if I click on that, it will open up Microsoft Stream and say, yep, there you go. There's the video. And away we go. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to close that browser window completely. Okay, so I've left everything, I've closed. So technically speaking, I'm completely out of, I've logged out of everything. So I'm just going to open up a new incognito window and I'm just going to log on to Teams, and I'm actually going to log on as one of my fake pupils. So let's go with Ark Pupil 1, that'll do. Good old Ark Pupil 1, I do like them. No, I don't want to say signed in. So when we log on as Ark Pupil 1, we will be able to have a look in Star Wars. He said, slowly, here we go. So let's have a look in Star Wars. And there's that video. So I'm just going to click on that video. It will take us to Microsoft Stream. And because I've already logged in as the web browser, I as Ark Pupil 1.
And we've there's got our a video. 15-minute window where I can record something. So this could be...
Okay, so that's actually pretty much it. There are some other options. Have a play with Microsoft Stream. See what you think. See what you want to play with. But that is pretty much the basics of Microsoft Stream. It's also worth noting, every time you record a meeting, so when we actually record things, it actually hosts it on Microsoft Stream as well. So all of your videos, whether you record them live in a class sort of context, or whether you're recording them sort of after hours and stuff, they're all actually on Microsoft Stream. And if we want to, obviously, let me just actually, before I finish, we're just going to go back to stream for a moment. I'll log back on as myself. So sign in. Yes, me. Thank you very much. So I've signed in as me. Obviously, we had that one video there. But I have done others, so if I just click on my content and videos, there's all my other stuff that I've been messing around with doing bits and pieces. So if I actually wanted to do something else, say I wanted to embed this test video, I can click on that test video, and again, it's exactly the same. I can just hit share down here, copy that link, and I can throw it straight into any channel that I want. It is that simple. So Microsoft Stream, it's a great little feature, great product from Microsoft, interfaces directly with Microsoft Teams, and again, you can create some fabulous materials and entertainment with it. So hope you found this fun and interesting, and I'll see you in the next one.